12th science physics chapter 2nd mechanical properties of the fluid. In last year, that is in 11th standard, we have studied the mechanical properties of the solids under the action of the applied force. We know that the solids have definite shape. They maintain their shape even if the large force is applied to them. But in case of liquids and gases, they have no their own shape. They take the shape of the container in which they are kept. Therefore, these liquids and gases flow under the action of the external forces. Hence, liquids and gases are called as fluids. A substance that can flow is called as a fluid. Again, we know that as the solids have definite shape, the mechanics of the solid is the mechanics of the rigid body. What is a rigid body? A body which have no deformation, any deformation, even if the large force is applied to it, such body is called as a rigid body. That is, the distance between any two particles of the rigid body remains the same, remains constant, even if the large force is applied to it. But as the liquids and gases have no their own shape, they change their shape regularly, continuously. Therefore, the mechanical behavior of the liquid and gases cannot be studied in the same manner as that of the solid. In this chapter, mechanical properties of the fluid, we will discuss the pressure exerted by the liquid, viscosity and surface tension of the liquid. Now, first we will discuss about the fluid. The substances which are capable to flow are called as fluid. What is fluid? The continuous deformation of the substance under the action of the applied force, it is called as flow. Suppose this is the fluid. If we apply the force to the fluid, then this fluid can continuously deform. Such continuous deformation, it is called as flow. Now, the liquids and gases, that is the fluids, undergo deformation by the application of external force. Now, the fluid is the phase of the matter which includes liquids, gases and plasma. Now, plasma, it is the fourth state of the matter which consists of gas of ions, free electrons and neutral atom. Plasma, it is the fourth state of the matter. It consists of gas of ions, free electrons and neutral atom. It occurs at the high temperature. Hence, the liquid, gases and plasma together are the fluids. Again, as the fluids have no definite shape, the modulus of rigidity, that is the shear modulus for the fluid, it is equal to zero. The value of modulus of rigidity for the fluid, eta, it is equal to zero. Eta, it is the ratio of shear stress to the shear strength. This eta, it is related to the shape of the body, as fluids have no definite shape. Hence, modulus of rigidity for the fluid is zero. Now, this fluid undergoes deformation by the application of the external force or the pressure gradient. Pressure gradient, it is the way to describe the difference in pressure from one location to another location. Here suppose one location, here suppose location second. Here there is high pressure, here there is low pressure. This pressure difference is from one location to another location is described in terms of pressure gradient. Hence, fluid is the substance that can deform continuously under the action of the applied force. air, water, molten lava, toothpaste, flower tube are the examples of the fluids. Now, to study the fluid, we use the concept of ideal fluid. Ideal fluid is the fluid which is incompressible and have no viscosity. It is called as ideal fluid. This ideal fluid, it is the imaginary, because all the fluids which are exist in nature have some value of viscosity. Therefore, there is no ideal fluid in the nature. With ideal fluid, it is the imaginary concept. This ideal fluid has so many properties. Ideal fluid, it is incompressible. What is incompressible? If there is no change in the volume of the fluid, even if the large force, large pressure is applied on it, then fluid is incompressible. That is, there is no change in the volume of the fluid. As its volume does not change, its mass is constant. Therefore, the density of this incompressible fluid remains constant. That is, rho, it is equal to constant. Hence, incompressibility is the rho, it is equal to constant. That is, volume flow rate of the fluid is constant, then fluid is incompressible. Second, the fluid flow is irrotational. If the fluid flow is smooth and there are no turbulences in the fluid flow, then such flow is called as irrotational flow. There are no whirlpools in the fluid motion, then such flow is also irrotational. If there is no net rotation of element of the fluid about its own axis, then such flow is called as irrotational flow. That is, when the fluid is flowing, the element of the fluid have no net angular velocity. The angular velocity of the element of the fluid is zero. Such flow is called as irrotational flow. In irrotational flow, the particles of the fluids, elements of the fluids move along the straight line. They move like this, along the straight line path. Such flow, it is called as irrotational flow. If the particles are moving like this, then such flow, it is called as rotational flow. Second property of the ideal fluid, that is flow, is irrotational. The third property, the fluid is non-viscous. If the fluid has no viscosity, that is, the internal friction between the layers of the fluid is zero, then such fluid is called as non-viscous fluid. When the fluid is moving, then if there are two layers of the fluid, if these two surfaces do not exert any tangential force on each other, then such fluid, it is called as non-viscous fluid. As the internal friction is zero, there is no loss of energy during the flow, there is no dissipation of the energy during the flow of the fluid. And the last fourth, that is, the flow is steady. The steady flow means if there is no change in the velocity of the fluid during the time, during the motion, then such flow is called as steady flow. When the fluid is flowing steadily, its velocity remains constant, that is, V is equal to constant. Therefore, mathematically, we can also write dv divided by dt, it is equal to 0. That is, the amount of liquid flowing per second through any cross section remains constant, then the flow of the fluid will be steady flow. In steady flow, velocity is constant. That is, if we plot the graph of velocity and against the time, then the graph will be velocity it is taken along y-axis, time it is taken along x-axis. This graph is parallel to the time axis. It is the straight line and parallel to the time axis. In steady flow, the elements of the fluid have constant velocity. It is important to distinguish between the solids and fluids. Now we will first discuss about the solids. In case of the solids can be subjected to shear, that is the tangential stress and normal stress. Solid can be subjected to shear and normal stress. What is shear stress? If we apply some force tangential to the surface of the body, then stress set up in the body, it is formed by the shear stress or tangential stress. If we apply force perpendicular, normal to the same area of the body, then stress developed in the body, it is called as normal stress. This normal stress is of two types. One, it is tensile stress, and second, it is compressive stress. If the applied force produces extension, that is the increase in the length of the body, then stress is called as tensile stress. If the applied force produces contraction, that is the decrease in the length of the body, then stress developed in the body, it is called as compressive stress. This shear stress, force is applied at tangential to some area, such stress it is called as shear stress. In normal stress, force is perpendicular normal to the area. In case of tensile stress, there is increase in the length of the body, there is extension of the body. Here the stress developed is tensile stress. Now in case of the compressive stress, the stress is developed of fat, there is contraction, that is the decrease in length of the body. That is, in solids can be subjected to shear and normal, that is the tensile and compressive stress. The second, in case of the solids, when we apply the force to the solids, then there gets deformed. But there is internal restoring force developed in the body which opposes the deformation. Therefore, in case of the body, the solids opposes the deformation and thus develop the restoring forces are strong. Third, the deformations in the solids are irreversible. Deformations in the solids are reversible. It is also important to distinguish between the solids and fluids. For solids, the solids can be subjected to shear, that is the tangential stress and normal stress. Shear stress means if the force is applied tangentially to the same area, then stress developed in the body, it is called as shear or tangential stress. If the force is applied normal, that is perpendicular to the same area, then stress developed in the body, it is called as normal stress. Now, for shear stress, tangential stress, this force is applied tangentially to some some area. It is applied tangentially to the upper area, then body gets deformed. Here it is shear tangential stress. Now the normal stress is of two types, that is the tensile stress and compressive stress. If the force is applied perpendicular, that is normal to some area, and if there is increase in the length of the body, there is extension produced in the body, then such stress, it is called as tensile stress. Their body force is applied like this, so that there is increase in the length of the body. Here the stress developed, it is called as tensile stress. If the force is applied to some, that force is applied perpendicular or normal to some area, and there is decrease in the length, that is the compression produced in the body, then the stress is called as compressive stress. Hence, for solids, solids can be subjected to shear stress and normal stress. But in case of the fluids, fluids can be subjected to normal compressive stress, and that is called as pressure. If we consider the small plane surface inside the solid, this surface do not accelerate, it remains steady, it remains constant. Hence, fluid applied the same and equal force on two sides of the surface. The fluid of this side exerts the force dF, fluid of this side exerts the force dF. This force is, it is equal in magnitude. Therefore, in case of the fluids, fluids can be subjected to normal compressive stress. The second point, the solid opposes the deformation. When we apply force to the solid, then in solid, internal restoring force is developed and it opposes the deformation. But in case of the fluids, such force developed is very weak, therefore fluids do not oppose the deformation. Or this opposition is very weak. The third point, in case of the solid, this deformation is reversible. In case of the solid, the molecules of the solid have strong cohesive force between them. Therefore, they try to regain their original shape. Hence, the deformation in the solid, it is reversible. But in case of the fluid, this deformation, it is irreversible. Because the elements of the fluid do not have such great enough cohesive force between them to hold these elements of the fluid together. Therefore, the fluids undergo deformation continuously. That is, the deformation in case of the fluid, it is irreversible. These are the points of distinguish between the fluids and solids. Therefore, for fluids, we can consider the properties. The first property, the deformation produced in the fluid, it is permanent. They do not oppose the deformation. Second, the fluids have ability to flow, and the third, fluids are able to take any shape of the container. they have ability to take the shape of the container. These are the properties of the fluid. Now, the branch of the physics which deals with the study of the properties of the fluids at rest, it is called as hydrostatic or fluid static. Static means still, at rest. Hydro, that is the liquid, that is the fluid. The branch of physics which deals with the study of properties of the fluids at rest, it is called as hydrostatic or fluid static. Here, we will discuss one interesting property of the liquid at rest, and it is the surface tension. Now, we know that some insects like ant, water spider, they are able to walk on the steady surface of the water. Grease and needle float on the surface of the steady water. Raindrops and soap bubbles are spherical in shape. Therefore, these are the examples related to the surface tension. Now, to study the surface tension, we need to know some terms. The first term, it is the molecular forces. Now, we know that matter, it is made up of molecules. The force between the molecules, it is called as molecular forces. These molecular forces are of two types. One, it is called as cohesive forces. And second, it is called as adhesive forces. The forces of attraction between the two molecules of the same substance are called as cohesive forces or force of cohesion. Here, the same substance, it is important, two molecules are of the same kind, are of the same substance. That is the force of attraction between the two molecules of the water, the force of attraction between the two molecules of the glass, the force of attraction between the one molecule of blackboard and another molecule of the blackboard. Such forces are called as cohesive forces. Now, in case of the solid, the cohesive forces are strong, but in case of the gases, they are very weak. Now, if there are some droplets of the liquid, then they combine to form a big droplet because of this cohesive force. Second, it is the adhesive force. The force of attraction between the two molecules of the different substances, different kind, it is called as adhesive force. That is the force of attraction between the one molecule of chalk and one molecule of blackboard. It is the adhesive force. Now, if we pour water on the glass, then the force of attraction between the molecule of water and molecule of glass, it is the adhesive force. Here, the substances are different, then the force of attraction between the two molecules of the different substance, it is called as adhesive force. One, that is, powder clings to our face because of this adhesive force. This is the first term, that is the molecular forces. Second, the range of molecular force. If this is molecule, then the molecular force can up to a certain maximum distance. This distance, it is called as range of molecular force or molecular range. Beyond this distance, the force, it is equal to zero. This distance is called as range of molecular force. The range of molecular force is the order of 10 raised to minus 9 meter, 10 raised to minus 7 centimeter, or it is 10 angstrom unit. Now, as this distance is very, very small, the molecular nuclear forces are short range forces. The third term, it is the sphere of influence. Now, suppose this is molecule. Taking molecular range as the radius, the image of this sphere is drawn around the molecule. This sphere is called as sphere of influence. That is, imagine this sphere with molecule at the center and molecular range as the radius. This image of this sphere is called as the sphere of influence. Molecule attacks. Get attracted by the other molecule lying within the sphere of influence. This sphere of influence is the range of the attraction of the molecules. Since molecules in the sphere of influence have experienced the molecular forces. The fourth term, surface field. Liquid is taken into a container. Let xy be the upper surface of the liquid. This xy, it is the plane surface of the liquid which is exposed to air. Now consider another plane surface of the liquid at a distance equal to the molecular range. Then it will be x' y'. Then the layer of the liquid between these two parallel planes, x, y and x' y', it is called as the surface film. The thickness of this surface film, it is of the range of molecular force. This x, y and x' y' are the two planes parallel to each other, then layer of the liquid having thickness equal to the molecular range is called as surface film. Hence, the surface film is the layer of the liquid which have thickness equal to the molecular range. And the last, it is the thin surface. The free surface of the liquid, it is defined as the plane surface which do not experience shear stress, which do not undergo shear stress, such it is called as free surface. That is, if xy, it is the upper surface of the liquid inside the liquid, which is inside, it is in the container. Then this xy, it is the free surface of the liquid. Now xy, here there is liquid, here there is air. This interface between the two dissimilar media, that is air and liquid, this xy, it is the free surface of the liquid. It do not undergo any shear stress. Such surface, it is called as free surface. For liquid, we have one free surface. For solid, we can consider many free surface. But in case of the gases, there is no free surface. Thus, in this lecture, we discussed about the fluids and some terms related to understand the concept of surface tension. These terms are molecular force, range of molecular force, sphere of influence, surface film and free surface.